Okay, good afternoon, everybody. Trust to all keeping safe and doing well at this time. My name is Dennis Zaga. I oversee digital innovation in the business banking group of First City Monument Bank. We thank you once again for joining us. We've been having a series of webinars in partnership with International Finance Corporation, and today we have another one, and it's about how do you leverage financing at this time during the COVID-19 challenges. Today we have a very experienced presenter in the person of Mrs. Sarah Mbiji. She's an entrepreneur. She has over 24 years experience and is a certified trainer with the IFC. I will hand over to her now, and I trust that you have a very, very interacting and very, very fulfilling time. Again, this is in keeping with our promise to always bring you webinars that will help you upskill. Thank you, and have a great time. Sarah, over to you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Dennis, for that wonderful introduction. And a very good afternoon to all our participants joining us here on Zoom and also on the YouTube channel. It's always a pleasure to have you on board. So as Dennis says, today we are doing a very interesting topic, which I'm sure touches each and every one of us in one way or another. And we want to talk about accessing finance during crisis. So that's what we are going to do today. Just kick off your boots, relax, you're in the right place, and enjoy the webinar experience. Let me start off by way of introduction, just by reminding you really that this series of webinars is being offered to you through a partnership between FCMB Bank and the International Finance Corporation. And I want to acknowledge the presence of our team leader. She's called Stella Masinda. Stella, it's great to have you on board. And without wasting any more time, I just want to say thank you so, so much for taking your time away from your very busy schedule to join us this afternoon so that we can discuss one or two things which we believe are going to help you in your business going forward. I need to bring to your attention that we are recording this particular webinar. I also want to introduce you, as I introduce myself, my name is Sarah Mbiji, and I'm a business owner just like you for the last 24 years. And out of those 24 years, 15 of them have been dedicated to helping people like you, SMEs, so that you can do better, you know, just solving the issues, the challenges that you have in business. And now we all know that we are facing the challenge of COVID-19, and we are here to help you. So we really just want to tell you that you are not walking this journey alone. We are with you, FCMB is here with you, IFC is here with you, and just feel at ease. I'm also an ILO business mentor, and so I mentor people like you, SMEs. I'm also an International Finance Corporation Certified Instructional Designer. Just a word to say that I develop content. I develop content, customize it, and localize it. So it doesn't matter where you are in Lagos, wherever somebody is, the world over, they would be able to understand this. I'm also an IFC certified trainer, and I'm happy to be on board. I'm not alone. I'm here with Jimmy Chakacha. And Jimmy, can you kindly just say hello to our participants? And also, very importantly, please tell them how to access the chat box so that we can make this presentation as interactive as possible. Over to you, Jimmy.
Thank you so much, Sarah, and a very good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us. My name is Jimmy Chakacha. I will be your moderator for today. And very quickly, I would like to acknowledge those who have started writing on the chat box. Thank you so much, Ibrahim, Kashmir, and Jerry. So very quickly, when you log in on your screen, when you hover around, there are two boxes, one which is written Q&A. You will use that box to write in your questions, and then we will take these questions at the end of the session. And then there's the chat box, We will use this one for the interaction that we will have with Sarah. So be sure to put in your comments and everything here. Thank you so much. Enjoy the session and back to you, Sarah.
Many thanks, Jimmy. Thank you so much for guiding our participants so that we can make the most out of the short time that we have available. Now, I would like us to start off with a small activity. As I've told you, I'm planning to engage you. So please, I need your participation so that we can make the most out of this time that we have together. I would like us to do an activity. And for once, I will allow you to close your eyes and imagine, envision a situation where you are given some money, maybe a partner, say FCMB came and asked you, would you like some additional financing? What would your answer be? I would like you to close your eyes, and I'm going to tell you when to start to do so, and just imagine what additional financing would do for your business. So I'm going to give you 30 seconds. Please close your eyes starting now. Awesome. So good afternoon, and you can open your eyes. Please go to the chat box. They say that when you have a dream, when you envision something, it's very important that you write it down, that you capture exactly what you saw. Kindly go to the chat box and tell me, what did you see? What are some of the things that additional financing can do for you in your business during this time of COVID? Please go to the chat box and talk to us. What did you see? What can that extra money do for you? I would like to ask Jimmy, do you see anything in the chat boxes? What would additional financing do for our guests this afternoon?
Sarah, Jimmy? Thank you so much. The feedback is coming very quickly, thick and fast. Mm-hmm. Allow me to take a couple of them as we proceed. So there's one, Joshua. Joshua says, I see expansion. Wow. Victor says, I see getting more business training and hired skilled labor. Henry says, great global business. Thank you so much. Another one says, I see myself doing business online and multiplying my funds. That is David. And then finally, Tunde says, expansion of my restaurant business. Shola says, I saw my business yielding more profits. Sarah, they are still streaming in. Please proceed as we take them up.
Wow. What would additional financing do for you? Thank you so much for sharing that exciting feedback for us. And that's exactly what we want to talk about this afternoon. There are two things that we want to talk about in terms of discussion. And the first one is the basics of borrowing. I have asked you to close your eyes and imagine what additional financing would do for you. And you're saying many, many things. So let's just remind ourselves what the basics in borrowing are. Has anything changed during COVID? That's what we want to understand. And then we want to look at how this pandemic of COVID-19 is affecting us and lending in particular. Is there anything that stands between us and accessing that finance? That's what we want to discuss. So by the end of the webinar, you should be very clear in your mind what you as a borrower would consider when you are going out to borrow. And on the flip side, what would the lender be looking at before they give you the funds? So we really want to help you to position yourself so that you can access finance as and when you need to. And then we look at how the pandemic has affected borrowing. And I will hand over to Dennis at the bank just to tell us if there's anything that they're doing as a bank just to cushion us or to help us as customers during this time. So as usual, we make it our business to help you. And we continue to reach out to you to help you as an SME, a business owner, to do a few things. This webinar will help you, number one, to adjust to the current crisis. There's a crisis and it's affecting all of us there in Lagos, here in Nairobi, and the world over. And the important thing is for us as business people to adjust and to continue to trade. And then secondly, we want to help you to be able to plan confidently. One of the reasons why people cannot plan confidently is because they cannot access financing. So they tell me, Sarah, I would love to plan, but if I can't access the money, if I can't get it, it means that there are very few things that I can do. So this webinar of accessing finance during this time is going to help you so that you can plan confidently into the future. We also want to help you to take advantage of borrowings that are available for you. Sometimes the funding is available, but customers, we don't know where to access the financing. So this webinar is going to help you to see where you can access financing and to take advantage of that, of those borrowing solutions, so that you can adapt in COVID-19 and also build your business as you take it forward. This crisis also presents an opportunity for you and me. Remember, I told you I'm a business owner. It gives us an opportunity just to sit down, to breathe, to take a, you know, these are the words of Barbara Corcoran, and she's a business person just like us. The only difference is that she's based in the US. She says that this time of the pandemic is a chance for you and I to breathe in and to put together a plan for your business in the next foreseeable future, which we are calling 1 year. And we are saying that we realize that one of the reasons why we cannot plan confidently is because we can't access finance. And that's exactly what this course wants to tackle this afternoon, so that we can have that experience. Now, some ground rules. It's important for us to just agree on how we are going to engage in the next very few minutes. Time flies. And just three things I want to point out to you. Number one, please participate. The more you participate, the more you will get out of this webinar. So I really want to thank you. When I'm asking questions, I can see the responses are coming in fast and thick. That's the way to go. Let's make this, let's make the most out of this time that we have together. Secondly, many, many things are going to be said in this webinar. And I know that you are all business people. That's the common ground here. And of course, also there's the bank, who is our host, who have invited us. Now, for those of us who have joined in, I know that you have been running your business for different lengths of time. Some of you are new in business, some of you are older in business, some of you are more experienced, some of you are less experienced, and so on. And so as we go through these conversations, I would just like to encourage us to put a premium on respecting every opinion that is voiced through the chat box. The chat box is our meeting ground. That's where you and I meet, through the chat box. So as many opinions are being voiced, what can help you in your business, please, by all means, take it, run with it, and let it work for your business. But what you think may not apply to your business now does not mean that it may not apply to your business in the future. So just pack it, you never know. You may need that good advice. Thank you so much for muting your microphones, and we can hear each other very well, very clearly, and also have your pen and paper. Just note down some of those things, some of those light bulbs that may come on, the light in your mind. Please have a piece of paper and pen and just capture that, you know, you never know. Of course, this content will also be given to you, so take it easy. Concentrate more on listening to me and let's engage because the content will be provided to you. Now, let's start off by way of introduction. I would like to ask you one question, just one question. And during this time of COVID, from March, there's March, April, May, June, July, and now we are in August. Have you been successful in accessing finance? Have you tried to access finance during this time? And did you succeed? Please go to the chat box and tell me, were you successful? Yes or no? I'll give you 30 seconds to do that. Did you succeed? Jimmy, can you kindly give me some feedback? Are our participants succeeding to get access to finance?
Sarah, thank you so much. As usual, the comments are coming in very thick and fast. There was one who said yes. Olusula said yes. Victor said no. There's another one says not on the organizational level. That is Julius. Someone says partially. I did not apply for any loan. Adempe says no. Kenneth says not with FCMB at the moment. Yes, but little. Adeoye says still in progress. Wow, but the huge amount says no here. They're passing up. Samuel, James, Ezeobiora says no. Hannah says no. Baba Wale says not at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it seems that we have a huge number of saying no. Back yes. to you, Sarah.
Thank you so much, Jimmy. There are varied responses coming in. Some are saying, I've not needed. Some are saying, I have tried. And those who have tried, some of them are saying, I have succeeded. Others are saying, partial, small. Others are saying, I would like more, and so on. Well, this webinar seeks to answer some of those questions or some of those reasons, perhaps, why you are not able to access financing. And I want to help you. I want to help you to know what you need to consider as a borrower and also what the financier is also considering so that we can sharpen our axes. And when we need that finance, we stand higher chances of getting it. So let us consider some basics in borrowing. And I want to ask you, because I know that you run your business, why might you need to borrow at this particular time? The first question I asked you was to dream and imagine what additional financing would do for you. Before COVID, there were officials who would visit us from the bank to tell us that there's funding available for us to borrow. But now this is driven by you as the borrower. Can you please go to the chat box and tell me why would you need to borrow during this COVID-19 era? What are some of the reasons that would drive you to try and seek additional finance? Please go to the chat box and talk to me. Jimmy, do we have responses coming in?
Yes, Sarah, the responses are coming in. Let me catch a few here as they go up.
Okay.
All right. Olayode says to meet up with customer demands. Tunde says to expand my restaurant business.
Mm-hmm.
Oyeyemi says to finance generator and working capital for my company.
Mm-hmm.
And then there is Nasiru Adetunji says to improve revenue. And then Bamgobola says to buy new equipments for my business. Henry says for expansion.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Jimmy. And thank you so much, our participants, for just talking to me and telling me why you would need to borrow. So different reasons. I'm borrowing because I want to expand my business. I'm borrowing because I need to buy a generator. I need to buy some equipment. And somebody tells us, I want to borrow so that I improve on revenue. I don't know whether you meant cash flow, but Jimmy told me that you said to improve your revenue. Now, that means that you need to have a reason why you are borrowing. And as a borrower, you don't just borrow for the sake of it. You don't borrow because somebody has asked you to borrow. You borrow because you have a legitimate reason why you are borrowing. So that's great. And these are some of the things that you have said. Maybe perhaps as a business person, I would need to borrow so that I step up my inventory, I increase my stocks so that I can meet the demand of my customers. That's one of the reasons why we would have to look for funds so that we can buy that stock or those materials or those items that are required for us to serve that customer. Remember, as a business person, you live to meet the need of your customer. So that's one reason. Another reason, I have had somebody saying, I need to buy a generator, I need to buy some equipment. Yes, you're actually on the right path. Sometimes we need to increase, we need to step up that demand. Or maybe, because there's this increase in demand, maybe your equipment has grown a bit old and it's not able, to produce as much for you. And during this time of COVID, you know, we need to have everything together. So you don't want to make those apologies, excuses, because you lose opportunities and you lose revenue. So maybe you want to invest in some state-of-the-art, equipment so that you can produce quickly and then you sell. That's another reason. Another reason is to meet cash flow gaps. We all know that because of COVID, our customers, in terms of demand, actually the demand has gone down. So they are not buying, their buying patterns may have changed depending on the product or the service that you are offering. And even for those who are buying, right now we know that our customers are very sensitive on prices. They really want us to, to push us down, and they could also be slow in paying. So in the event that your customers are a bit slower to pay, and yet you need to pay the suppliers and so on, that's what we are calling a cash flow gap. And that's one of the reasons that would compel us to borrow. Note that we are borrowing because we have a reason, maybe to cover certain costs. Maybe you are reorganizing, restructuring yourself internally in terms of the tools of trade, in terms of your people. Maybe you're investing in technology. We now know that even us here in Africa, for a long time, we have shied away from technological advancements. But now we are seeing that going digital is the way to go. And perhaps you need to make certain investments to position your business to do better in this new normal. So perhaps maybe you're even thinking of going online now that customers cannot come to you. You need to go to them. So maybe you need to invest putting together a website, and you need some help. The issue here, what we are saying, is that there is a reason that is compelling you to borrow. Maybe you're thinking of that growth and expansion. And we're saying the COVID-19 period is an opportunity for us as business people to take a deep breath, and to plan for the future. And it is perfectly in order for you to plan for expansion. Now that you are very clear on the need, what is pushing you to look for additional financing, the next thing that you need to do is to do some window shopping. Go and do some window shopping. So you ask yourself as a business person, how much money do I need? And how much time do I have? And where is the best place to get this money from? So there are different places that we could get this money from. Number one, your personal savings as a business person. So if you had been setting aside some money to use for a rainy day, that rainy day has come. It's here with us in COVID. So you can access those personal savings. I know there are some of us who have also been saving as a business, and we have always been encouraging business owners, don't spend everything. Please save. Teach your business to save. So in the event that perhaps you had been saving, what I've seen some people doing, for example, if your business has two directors, at the end of the year, when you look at your performance, you need to remember that you need to pay not two directors, but three. Who is the third director? Savings. Once you know that I have a third director called the savings account, it means that you will share that profit equally, perhaps, and that third director, who we are calling the savings account, gets some money as well. So you had been saving. Now in your hour of need, you need to access that. As you do your window shopping and you're looking around, considering where to access this finance from, one of the quickest places to access finance is your savings. Now here, whether they're your personal savings or your business savings, there's no cost to it. Why? Because the money is yours. Terms and conditions, you don't have to sign any dotted line. You just need to access it. It's easy, it's cheap. There's no cost to that. That's an advantage. And then a disadvantage is a risk of loss, because there's a way that, you know, your ATM, the bank will always be calling you, you know, because you know that you have some money there. So you have to be very clear on what you want, the purpose of that, you know, the purpose of the additional finance is, and then you use it for that purpose. So as you're window shopping, you're exploring pros and cons. Another place that we can get money is from our friends, our relatives, our friends and family. Now, when it comes to the cost, this one is very flexible. You just need to have a discussion with them and tell them, you know what, Sarah, please, if you have some money, please help me. I need to, you know, get some stocks. I need to pay a supplier. I need to pay my staff, my rent, and so on. Very flexible. We just have a conversation between the two of us. And it is readily available. It's flexible. And I can actually just go ahead and give you the money. What have you just done? You've accessed finance. The flip side of that, the disadvantage, is it can cause a lot of friction. Many relationships, many friendships have been broken down simply because of borrowing, accessing finance. And so one starts off very well, something happens in the middle, and some, you know, it can really destroy a relationship. So that is just another way of accessing finance. Another one, if you are in a table banking, I know a lot of us women are involved in this table banking options. You can go there and you can access your finance. If you had a SACCO, you're a member of a SACCO, and you were putting some money there, you can also access it. It's part of your, you know, savings. But here, to the extent that you may be able to borrow even up to 5 times the size of your savings, that's another option. What are we doing here? Window shopping. Another access to finance is through our suppliers. These are people who supply you those products that you're going to sell to a customer with the understanding that you will pay them back later. What has that supplier done? They've actually just given you access to financing, and you can trade with that money during the period that you agreed with them, and then you repay back. So the terms will vary according to your ability to negotiate with your supplier. So an advantage is it is inexpensive. When you compare, remember we are window shopping, with other places where you can get money and the cost of that borrowing, this one is inexpensive and it is also unsecured. It's on a trust relationship. And because it is on a trust relationship, you need, as a business person, to protect the integrity of that relationship that you have with your suppliers. A disadvantage, very short term. For us as business people, 30 days, 15 days is like the twinkling of an eye. So it is very short term in nature. And secondly, it is restricted to the product or service that has been offered. So for example, if I am training, and indeed I am training, and I engage the services of my friend Chakacha, and I tell him, please come and help me to facilitate this training, and I will pay you at the end of the month, that credit is only restricted to the services that Jimmy Chakacha will give me during the time period that I have agreed with him. I'm giving these examples because I know some of us are in the service industry, others are in the, you know, products industry. Another place where you can get money is the banks. And as I'm speaking to you this afternoon, I know that you have different banks. We are multi-bank. So you get, so as you do your window shopping, you need to look around and see who's offering credit and what are the terms and conditions. That's why I'm saying there the terms will vary depending on who is giving you the credit. Now, when we talk about funding, access to finance, we're talking about it's about cash flowing into your business. So you'll ask yourself, how much cash is it? If it's small, I can go to table banking. I can go to my savings, depending on how much savings I have, friends and family. But if I want to do a serious project, like what you're telling me, I want to expand my business. I want to look for that equipment. Your bank, I always say your bank is your best friend. Please approach your relationship manager. And because the cash is available, they can have a very good conversation with you. Once they understand what is the purpose of your financing, they'll be able to give you a solution that is best suited to help you as a business person. And it is a win-win. A disadvantage is it's sometimes very hard to qualify for. Why? Because it's other people's money. So when the bank does due diligence, don't feel bad about the bank. They are just taking the precautions. Why? Because it is other people's money. Then, of course, there's also the financiers, and they have a different set of arrangement depending on what you need the money for, depending on what, why you need the money and what are the terms and conditions. Some of them will say, I want to come inside your business. Let's run. Let's make the decisions together. Some of them will not. So it varies. So it is easy to get. You can get it immediately. The requirements are few. We have examples like Kiva. We have Enablis. We have Growfin and so on. Some of them are international, some of them are local, but they'll give you the kind of solution you're looking for and that money that you're looking for. Then a flip side is that it can turn out to be very expensive. So what are we saying here? You have a need. Once you're clear on why you need that money, go out and start doing some window shopping. So I want to ask you a question. When you are now at that stage where you want to borrow, you're ready. I want to borrow money. What are some of the things that you consider? Please go to the chat box and please indulge me. Talk to me and tell me, what do you consider when you want to go and borrow? What are some of the things you consider? Jimmy, can I kindly ask you to tell me, what are some of the things that our guests consider when they're ready to borrow?
Yes, Sarah. So one says, I consider cost of borrowing. Mm-hmm. I consider tenor. I consider, just a second. I consider the rate of return. Mm-hmm. Obina says payment of the loan. Mm-hmm. Erasmus says interest rates. And there's one, Ogunsi says advantages and disadvantages.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, our participants, for telling us. And really, indeed, this is the truth of the matter. You need to consider, what is the cost of that borrowing? What about my ability to repay? And especially now during COVID, what is the purpose of the loan? Because the purpose of the loan will help you to decide, to make decisions. Is it short term? Is it long term? The other thing you'd ask yourself is how much, the amount. You know, you'd ask yourself, are they going to ask me for security? Are they going to ask me for collateral? Is it secured, unsecured? What about the reputation of the lender? Those are some of the things that we ask ourselves. And this slide here really is just to summarize what you have already told me, because you are experienced business people. We do consider the cost of the borrowing, which is what we are calling the interest rate. We do consider the charges. Is there a processing fee? How much is it? Am I required to get insurance? How much is it? Are there any other costs that I should expect to incur? Those are some of the things that we consider. We also look at the loan repayment period. This is the time period that you're going to use to repay day, you'll organize yourself as a business person. So is it short term? Is it long term? Those are questions that you must answer before you decide to go ahead and borrow. Then, of course, there's the issue of security, collateral. Is there something, is there an asset that you have which you will pledge in exchange to get that, money? And then, of course, the grace period. Is there a moratorium? These are some of the questions you will ask yourself. But then the lender on the other side, because they're looking at you as a business, they need to get assurance about the profitability of your business. Have you thought about certain things? There are many questions that you would ask yourself. You need to ask yourself as a business person before you even go and borrow. That's why, okay, when you go to a financial, it could be the bank, it could be a venture capitalist or something like that, they'll ask you, do you have a business plan? What is the money for? And when you explain, they'll tell you, wow, that sounds great. Just bring for me your business plan. The business plan will answer a lot of questions which are written there on that slide. It will tell us something about the profitability of your business. I recall that we did, FCMB Bank did a webinar on surviving today to thrive tomorrow. And there we looked at the whole issue of profit and profitability. That's critical. Will the business have the ability to continue to generate profit during this time of the COVID pandemic? Those are questions that will be answered there. And then there's solvency and there's liquidity. We are looking at the ability of your business to generate cash flow in the short term, which we call liquidity, and the long term, which we call solvency. And of course, the lender will try to get an indication as to your history. Had you taken a loan before with us? And how were you servicing that loan? What kind of a person were you? So those are some of the things that they will consider. And I want to take you through the five C's of lending, some of the things that FCMB Bank is going to be looking for or looking at as they scrutinize, as they make that decision as to whether they will give you, they will advance the credit to you or not. What am I doing? I'm helping you to get into their mind so that you position yourself. When you go to the bank, you are armed and you're ready to go. Those five C's, we call them five C's because they all start with C. There's the character, collateral, capacity to pay, the conditions, and capital. Let's look at them one by one. Character. So as we look at Chakacha, are you there?
Yes, Sarah.
Can you hear me loud and clear?
Very, very clear.
Awesome. Just checking because I have some important things that I want to tell our participants.
So, all right.
Number one, character. What kind of a person are you? Even before COVID, you see, now we're talking about accessing finance in a time of crisis. Now, this is where your character is going to earn a lot of bonus points for you. What kind of a person were you? When you were given a loan, were you repaying it? Were you repaying it according to the terms and conditions? And we know that as business people, sometimes we encounter challenges. That's normal. It is normal for us to encounter challenges in the ordinary course of doing business. But when you encounter a challenge, what kind of a person are you? Do you keep quiet? When the relationship manager calls you, you don't pick up your phone. You change your number. You go under the water. What kind of a person are you? So when we're saying that facing challenges is normal in business, if you encounter a challenge, reach out to your relationship manager and tell them, look, I'm having this challenge, but I'm working on it. What does that tell us? A lot about your character. What about your personal disciplines? You know, personal disciplines has everything to do with your character. When you get a payment, for example, you have been paid by a supplier, a customer somewhere. Are you disciplined to actually, if you are paid through maybe, you know, previously we used to handle cash, and I know some of us still handle cash small here and there, though it's not encouraged because of COVID. I know a lot of us are bank, you know, using online banking, mobile banking platforms and so on. Are you the kind of person who deposits whatever payments you get in cash? Do you deposit them into the account, or you get them and then you meet your friend and say, let's go and eat fufu? Discipline. What are we talking about? Discipline. And when you get money into the account, are you able to keep it there? Are you disciplined? Because if you're disciplined with your own money, I know that you're going to be disciplined with my money as a lender. That's what I'm looking at. Character. That's why we have credit reference bureaus, to give us an indication about your character. So your character is very, very important. And even right now in COVID, that is also, you know, something really essential and fundamental that we're looking at. The other thing we're looking at is a collateral. This money that you're asking for, does it have to be secured? Do you have to exchange a certain, asset to pledge it in exchange, just in case something goes wrong? Now, my advice to you is, when you think about what to give as collateral, brothers and sisters, do not pledge as collateral an asset that your business is using to generate revenue. Because in the event that something goes wrong, it can actually affect your livelihood if that particular asset goes. So look at your assets. I know some of us, you know, in terms of our asset base, it could be limited depending on so many things, but be cautious about that. The other thing is capacity to pay. And this is something that we're really looking at, especially during COVID. What is the ability of your business to continue to generate revenue? Meaning that you have to have a good reason why you're expanding, why you're investing in that equipment, why you want to expand. What is driving that? The customer. It's the customer's demand. So if the customer is demanding for those products or services, it means that holding all factors constant, your business will be able to generate revenue to run itself and also to repay the loan. Capacity to pay. Another thing we look at in capacity to pay is, to what extent do you have other loans or debts? So yes, you have all these good ideas. You want to buy a generator, equipment, and wonderful. That's great. But then do you have other existing loans? That could tell us something about capacity to pay. And then there's conditions. Conditions, I think the big one which has overtaken everything is COVID. And then there's also the capital. Yes, you need money, but how much have you invested into your own business? That will tell me something about the seriousness, the stake that you have in that business. The more you invest in your business, the more we can talk. You see, sometimes people feel trade with other people's money. Now, you have to form, you know, you have to get a balance. So that's what we call the 5 C's of lending. Now, let's quickly look at the pandemic's effect on lending. And here we're looking at a few things. Number one, are there any changes in borrowing considerations? And these are questions that perhaps FCMB needs to answer. Are there any special COVID special support for us as customers during this time? What about related customer service measures? You see, sometimes, in fact, most of the time, we're not able to, you know, go to the bank. How about, you know, the outreach to us as customers? They'll be telling us more about it. And what about those loans that we had taken before now, and perhaps we are struggling to repay? Those are some of the questions that are at the top of our minds. And I would like to hand over to Dennis. Dennis, if you can kindly take over and please speak to the customers and tell them, what are you doing? Dennis, are you there?
Yes, I'm here. Thanks, Sarah.
Over to you.
Yeah, thank you. It's been great so far. So let me quickly put up the slides. There are just 2 slides. And first, I'll speak in the context of what FCMB has done independently, and then the next slide we'll talk about what we are doing in conjunction with the regulatory bodies and DFIs. So we have a very interesting digital loan for SMEs that is essentially without collateral. I'm sure this is something all SMEs are very excited to hear. So we're not asking you to bring any assets to collateralize the lending. We're not asking you, as some people jokingly say, we're not asking you to bring your mother, your grandmother, or your grandfather. So it's a short-term financing. It's between 3 to 6 months. You can get up to 10 million naira, and it's an effective rate of 2.5% per month. And during the pandemic, we had to restrict, at the start of the pandemic, we had to restrict it to essential segments like food, health, and pharmaceuticals. We've opened it up a bit more to more sectors, but we're still watching to ensure that there are no inherent risks. But that's something that is available right now. It's short-term, it's working capital finance, and it's available without collateral. What other things that we did was that we extended the loan repayment, we created a loan repayment moratorium on all our loan products. So this is inclusive of what are called the normal loan products like term loans, which are collateralized. You need to bring collateral for that. And if you have receivables, we can discount them. You know, so we extended the loan repayment moratorium on all those products, periods within 90 to 120 days. Further to that, we also extended, we also had moratorium extension up to 12 months. Remember, the first one was within 90 to 120 days, but we also extended for up to 12 months on principal repayments, loan principal repayment. That is effective from March 1st this year. Also, we are working closely with the CBN to implement the regulatory forbearance efforts to temporarily restructure term loans, tenured loans for businesses most affected by COVID-19, particularly the oil and gas, agriculture, and the manufacturing sector. If you quickly move to the next slide, thank you. So this is focusing on what we're doing with the regulators and DFI. So we're working closely with this, collaborating with the CBN on lending of their new 100 billion Naira health sector intervention fund. So please come in to reach us on our digital handles, come into any branch and ask for how you can access this through FCMB. Also, in line with the regulatory statement given by the CBN, regulatory rent lending on lending has been reduced effectively from 9% to 5% for 1 year, effective March 1st. Also working closely with DBN, Development Bank of Nigeria, to offer customers moratorium on principal and interest for 90 days, and also the rate reduction on new facilities, like I said, effectively 5% now. Then working closely with the CBN and availed through NESAL Microfinance Bank, there's a 50 billion Naira SME loan facility available. That's also at 5%. So please feel free to contact us, come into, walk into any FCMB branch, or there's an email address that we'll be publishing at the end of this session. SMEHelpDesk@fcmb.com. You can reach us on that email and we will engage you. There are two quick questions that Jimmy has asked me to quickly respond to. So there's a consortium from Deakin Kingsley, Kano. There's a consortium who has real estate development, PPP with Lagos State Government. This is a specific request. I would like you to reach us on that email so that we can continue the engagement. Also, the recording will be made available. I'll speak to that at the end. Those who have fears that banks hide charges and other elements from them at the point of issuing the loan, this fear is assuaged really because we always give you an offer letter that contains all the terms and conditions. So I think that's all I'll say for now. Sarah, back to you. I'll say some more at the end.
Thank you so much. And I think it's a lot of good news that you're giving customers there. We say information is power. And Dennis says, yeah, there's a lot of misconceptions about many things. And sometimes we're not clear. So we are here to clarify, to give you information so that you make the right decisions. Now, perhaps you're telling me, Sarah, I've tried everything, seriously speaking, for the last 5 months since March to date, and I'm really struggling. I'm saying that that's normal, especially during this COVID dispensation. So you may find that as you're running your business, you find that you're skipping a payment. That's what we're calling delinquency, or perhaps one or two or three others. That's what we're calling default. What are we saying here? Reach out to your relationship manager. Reach out to the person that you took the loan from with a view to restructuring. Keep the communication channels open, effective communication that we were told about. So really, the person inside there is anyone who has lent you money. Doesn't matter whether it is the bank, whether it is your friend, whether it is a SACO, whoever it is, they don't like surprises. So please be proactive. Reach out to them, communicate to them what the challenge is, and you know, let them be in the know so that you can manage your, you know, the expectations of everybody across the board. Now, this pandemic definitely opens up borrowing opportunities. And sometimes for you as a business person, sometimes what you just need is that boost, that assistance from a friend or a partner to kickstart you to implement these things that you're thinking of implementing. So I know that my advice to you is you need to plan. You know, planning has not stopped with COVID-19. We still continue to plan. And when it comes to access to financing, what are the options that I have available? You need to, you know, plan and see what works best for you. I know I have done a lot of talking, and I'm going to ask that you just go to the chat box and please let me know, what is the one thing, the main thing that you have learned out of this webinar? What is the main thing that you have learned? What is the key learning based on this webinar that you have received as a result of access to finance? Jimmy, do you have anything coming through?
Yes, Sarah, I'm on standby, and I would like to acknowledge all those who are sending in their comments. Mm-hmm. Olabisi says, I've learned character is key. Tunde said, I've gained insight on how FCMB is assisting businesses during this time. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you. Character is at the core of your effectiveness as a business person. When it comes to transactions with your suppliers, when you say, I will pay you by this date, pay. What are we talking about? Character. So thank you so much for that feedback. We have now come to the end of the webinar. There are two things that we agreed we wanted to look at. One is a refresher on the borrowing basics and the effect of the COVID-19 on lending. We said that when you get to the end of the webinar, you should be very clear on what the basics are. What are the basics for you as a borrower? What do you need to consider? And then what is the financier considering on the other side before they make a decision to, you know, give you, you know, that access to credit? We looked at the five C's. Character is only one of them. There's also collateral. There's also capacity to pay. There's also conditions, and there's also capital. And then we had a discussion. We've heard from Dennis what FCMB Bank is doing to assist us or to cushion us. So what are the next steps? Number one, you need to have that plan. Think about it. And in that plan, please make plan to continue to make profits and remain profitable in COVID and beyond. Plan to manage your cash flow, the cash flowing in and out of your business. If you don't manage your cash flow, you'll not be able to manage your debts. And you need to adapt to the crisis and plan going forward. If you need to, please reach out to that person who gave you that financing, whether it is the bank, whether it is a friend, whether it is a relative, whoever they are. and have a discussion with them on the current borrowing that you have with them and also going forward. I think FCMB is open to listening to you, and in the event that they need to lend you or to help you, they will certainly be able to do so. Remember that this is a series of webinars we are offering to you. We have done a few, but the one that we're doing today is accessing finance during this time of crisis.
So for those of you who are asking about the presentation and the slides, there's an email on the screen. Please drop us your email on that one and the presentation will be sent back to you. Thank you so much for staying with us. Thank you for your very much contribution.
Thank you, Jimmy. Thank you, everyone. I can see some questions popping up. So for those who have specific questions, FCMB is positioned to lend to you. Like I said, we have a loan product that does not require collateral. That is in addition to the normal loan products where you need to bring collateral. And interesting information is that it's for specifically women-owned and women-managed businesses. We actually have an initiative where we lend at 0%. You know, so again, I urge you to please come into the closest FCMB branch, send us an email at the email address smehelpdesk@fcmb.com, or you can also reach us on our SME digital platform, which is currently up on the screen, which is businesszone.fcmb.com. All our past webinar series, especially everything from the ones we've hosted and the ones we've done in partnership with IFC, they are all on the Business Zone. You can always go back there. Most of the questions I'm seeing now, we've already spoken to them. So you can just go there, quickly register, just a few steps to register, and you can view those videos. All the questions taken here, all the questions you've asked here, we will answer them and we'll publish the questions and the answers on the Business Zone. Please watch out for further communication. We thank you for making our time to join us, and please continue to tune in as we have much more to give to you, and especially in partnership with IFC. Thank you and have a great day.
FCMB, my bank and I.